Today I'm going to try and capture an ISS solar transit. In order to do that, I need to be able to capture 70 frames per second, and I haven't been able to do that yet. So I've got a couple of different external hard drives I'm going to be testing. So for the test, I have a 7200 RPM hard drive, a 5400 RPM hard drive, and a solid state hard drive. I need to have a goal of around 60 to 75 frames per second. For this test, I'm going to stick each one of those hard drives into an external drive enclosure and see how fast SharpCap can write frames to the drive. So we're going to connect to the ASI camera. We have the 7200 RPM hard drive connected. We're going to change our capture settings down to 1/8000th of a second. We're going to have the color space mono 16. And we're going to change the capture resolution to high definition, 1920 by 1080. These settings are going to be the same for each capture. We're going to capture 20 seconds worth of video using the quick capture. We're going to ensure that the settings are writing to the D drive, which is the external hard drive. With all the settings confirmed, we begin our first 20 second capture on the 7200 RPM hard drive. It starts off at 75 frames per second, but it quickly drops to about 9 frames per second average. With the capture complete, we switch to the 5400 RPM hard drive. Leaving all of the settings the same, I'm going to redo the 20 second capture. This time, it starts off close to 30 frames a second and drops down to 9 to 10 frames per second average. With the test complete, I'm going to switch to the solid state drive. With the settings all the same, I redo the same 20 second capture to the solid state drive. The hard drive starts off quickly at 50 frames a second and then drops off to 9 to 10 frames per second average. What this tells me is that a 4-year-old solid state drive is no faster than a 7200 RPM regular laptop hard drive. I need a faster hard drive solution, and it just so happens that I was testing this last week already and decided I was going to go on a limb and buy a new solid state hard drive. So let me show you the Samsung T5 1TB external solid state hard drive. I think that this uses a next generation mobile SATA drive, which is similar to what's in the solid state drive here. The difference is this uses really old VNAND technology, I think. This should have Samsung's latest and greatest solid-state storage technology. If we're lucky, it's that 3D VNAND technology that they use in all of their really fast hard drives.
So I want to do a good old-fashioned unboxing. So this thing is already pretty small. If we compare it to the solid state drive I was using before, you can see that it's got about 1 or so inches less in length, and its height is about a 1/2 inch shorter. So it's got a single USB Type-C connector. It uses USB 3.1 Gen 2 that supports up to 10 gigabits per second data transfer. But the drive inside is still a mobile serial ATA. That means it only supports up to 6 gigabits per second transfer from the USB to the actual drive itself. We've got an instruction manual nobody will read, and two USB cables. One is a USB Type-A to USB Type-C, and the other one is USB-C to USB-C. My Intel Compute Stick won't take this, but my laptop will. For the purposes of the test, I want to use Type-A to Type-C. All the settings are the same. We're going to do another 20-second quick capture. And there was a little bit of a sag at the beginning. It went down to 60 frames per second, but it is holding steady right around 74 to 75 frames per second. This new hard drive really does write a lot faster than even my old solid state hard drive.
So I've got the hard drive figured out. I can capture frames as fast as I need to in order to do a clear ISS transit of the sun later today. The only thing I need to hope for is that the weather holds out. There is still just one more test I need to do. How fast can my Intel compute stick write to that hard drive? Let's figure that out now. On the Intel Compute Stick, I connect to my ASI camera. With the camera connected, all I need to do is just change my settings back to how they were on my laptop. For that, I change the color space back to Mono 16. I change the frame rate to 1/8,000th of a second. And the capture area I change back to full HD, 1920 by 1080. Now I just need to check my sharp cap settings to ensure I'm going to write to the D drive. Right now it wants to write to an E drive, and I don't know where that is. Oh, it's the Samsung. With all of the settings the same as they are on my laptop, all I need to do is the same 20-second capture that I did for all of the other tests. So it looks like it's going to hold steady at about 50 frames per second instead of 75 frames per second. And my guess is that my laptop has a 3.1 Gen 2 port, and this USB hub is strictly USB 3.0. It's not as fast as the integrated USB to my laptop, but still 50 frames a second is 9 to 10 times faster than what I was able to write before, and that is a huge improvement.